Tampered with nature, now they must pay the price. See the grotesque invade an unsuspecting village. See a hospital panic when day-old babies go berserk. See friends turn on each other in a nightmare of horror. You'll cringe with terror when you see. Don't open the window. Whatever's out there will wait. Rated R.
Thank you. it moving. Keep it moving there.
All right, just get that formaldehyde into the truck.
All right.
I hate that smell.
Formaldehyde had never hurt anyone.
Do you ever embalm anyone, Doctor?
They're strictly for the undertakers.
None of these old pipes haven't given away altogether.
We don't have money for repairs. And anyway, they won't have to last another 3 months. Then it'll be the end of this whole damn place.
You'll be reassigned, Warden.
No. There's no reassignment for me. My kind is finished. Country clubs and honor farms they want now. This letter came from the Department of Correction this morning. You're all reassigned. Every guard, every prisoner, and you, Dr. Saunders. They said, I'm not oriented enough in the new system.
Keep it moving. Out of here tonight, huh?
Not if we stand around and talk about it, we won't.
Yeah.
Hi, Carol.
Hello, Paul. Have they told you where you're going to be transferred to yet?
No, not yet.
The couple that own the trailer court are going to close it down and move on. I'm going to have to find someplace else to live.
I'll still see you every day, won't I?
Well, it ain't no picnic driving out here every day. Working that cafe, being felt up by salesmen and truck drivers?
Well, I was beginning to think that maybe, damn it, you liked it.
Well, maybe I do.
Johnson. Come here. You got 1 minute. Go on, don't spoil a good thing. You got 1 minute. Johnson, right now. Come on, move.
I don't want to be late for work.
End of the barracks.
Why?
Do as I tell you.
Unless you want to come with us, you can do more than hold that pretty little girl of yours. You can do it tonight. You can do it right. She sure is pretty, isn't she? Come here.
Make our way to the warehouse shed. Then we're gonna crawl through the tunnel to the bushes on the other side of the fence. And it's just a short walk to the loading depot. Okay? Exactly 9:30. When the lights out whistle blows, I turn this key to the ignition of the flatbed.
But McGee's out there right now.
Who are you concerned about, McGee or us? McGee has a gun. We need a gun. Oh, I remember McGee let you hold your old lady for a little while. I see. That's right. Anybody that even smells like trouble in this break is dead. He's no Mitchell. He knows rules.
I hope they kill you, Braddock. Some of us deserve to be in here and some of us don't, but I hope they kill you.
I'll choke him with my hands.
No, you won't. Because there'll be a riot in here, and Braddock wouldn't want that. No.
He's got a better use for all of you. Or he wouldn't have made your mind simple, feeding you all that formaldehyde vapor.
Come on, Donovan. It's time to move.
Men, back to your bunks. Move it!
This man's still alive.
Braddock.
Oh. Some of you men give me a hand here, please. Yeah, right. Easy, easy.
Come on, over there. Get your gun.
In the car.
I'll go over the depot.
Let's go.
It was an accident. It was an accident! It was an accident! It was an accident!
You're going to hell, you little son of a bitch.
These men don't deserve this, Warden.
I'll decide that, Doctor. Braddock lived in agonizing pain 48 hours longer than the rest of them. He, too, shall be tossed into a shallow, unmarked grave without dignity, as they were. Now, the same thing goes for any of you who attempt to escape from this camp or any other camp you're transferred to. You six men knew of the escape, and yet you said nothing. You shall remain here for 3 days on bread and water.
This sort of punishment was outlawed years ago, Warden.
You shall stay here for 4 days, Mitchell. And I shall add one additional day for every word I hear from any of you. Officer McGee was murdered because you chose to say nothing. Take it away.
Such a fog or a chill like this.
Keep moving there.
Yes, Mr. Wilson.
Oh!
Mr. Wilson? Wilson.
Mr. Wilson. They won't let me go. Jake! Jake, don't leave me. Don't leave me, Jake. Don't go away, Jake. Help me. Help me, Jake. Help me. Please help me. Help me, Jake. Hey.
Must have the liquid back at the camp. We will destroy the living. We will destroy the living.
This will help you to sleep, Carol.
I can't sleep thinking about Paul.
Now, Paul's going to be all right. He was lucky. I'm going to have him transferred to the county hospital in a couple of days, and he'll get good treatment there. You'll be able to get an apartment in the city. Now, you just relax, and this drug will take effect real soon. And when you awaken, this horrible nightmare will be all over. And you and Paul will be together again, all right?
Thank you, Pop.
Very nice of you to take care of Carol the way you did, Mrs. Fleming.
Oh, that's all right. She couldn't stay alone in that old trailer she rented. Doesn't even have hot water.
I'll stop in again tomorrow. Good night.
That's good.
Johnson, what is it? What is it? What's the matter?
What's the matter? But, sir, the girl's in a bad way.
I don't care what the situation is. You tell Jablonski to get back inside and lock the gate. And quick. Damn quick.
Yes, sir. Jablonski? The warden wants you back inside, right now!
Braddock.
Come on, Mrs. Johnson.
What the warden said!
The hell with what the warden said! You just locked that gate behind us. Come on, Mrs. Johnson.
What's this all about, Jablonski?
I don't know, Warden. I don't know if I can find the right words to tell you what I just saw.
Why'd you just try?
It looked like Braddock and maybe Nolan and Kohler and Donovan, all of them just coming down the road.
Take my office. Have Dr. Saunders look at her.
Yes, sir.
Get the generator going.
Yes, sir.
What do you see out there?
Just a broken power line, Ward.
Put a call into the electric company.
Yes, sir. This phone is dead, sir.
All right. I'll call him from my office then. Get some light out here.
Put some power here, sir.
What caused it, Warden?
I don't know.
The phones are all out, too.
Sergeant, I want every man to his emergency post.
Yes, sir. Shall I send somebody out here to pick up his body?
No. You take it back with you now. I want no one out here alone. Now, do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Well, look, all you men, I want you to stay together. Keep your flashlights on the bushes along the sides of the road.
Yes, sir.
Looks like somebody got to him with an axe.
Braddock was carrying an axe.
Don't talk foolish.
Johnson's wife said a group of men attacked the trailer court tonight and killed a man and woman in the same way.
Warden, believe me.
I saw Braddock and the others.
Issue every man 2 boxes of ammo.
Yes, sir. Warden, what about the prisoners in the yacht?
So far, Jablonski, nothing has happened inside the camp. Prisoners stay where they are.
But I saw Braddock and the others.
No. You saw somebody. So did I. But you didn't see any dead men.
Thank you.
There's lots of tracks, sir. It looks like they all came inside.
Sergeant, form search parties, each one taking a section of the camp.
Yes, sir.
Let one of us drive to town, sir. We can call the sheriff's station at Wrightwood.
There's nothing here we can't handle ourselves, Jablonski.
It's Cola.
Yes.
Vehicles are useless.
Useless? What are you talking about?
Ah.
your youngest and fastest man, get him to run in the direction of Wrightwood. Tell the sheriff there we need assistance.
Yes, sir.
Ah! You go. Get that runner going.
Yes, sir.
All right, you men, hit the floor.
Shoot, Warden, for God's sake, shoot!
A shotgun at close range is our only chance. Generator plant.
Why there?
They'll be safe there. That building's made of reinforced concrete.
What?
Yes.
I said Bob Lindgren. He was a long distance runner in high school.
Damn! Damn! Yes. Give me those keys quickly.
Yes,
take this. There's something around us, Warden. You back off and keep your flashlight on the compound.
Yes, sir.
What's this about Braddock, Donovan, and Kohler? Now, look, I'm going to unchain you, men. I want you to run to the generator plant, and I want you to remain there. Remain there with the rest of them.
Warden's dead. Help me carry him to his room.
Yeah. Yeah. Why not, Jablonski?
Because these old walls won't keep them out.
You better let Johnson rest for a while.
Decomposes them almost instantly. It'll give us some protection while we're walking over to that generator plant.
We'll be safe now.
Sergeant Burns, get out there and cover the guards while they're getting the light down.
Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. You help, too.
I got it.
Their chance, but they didn't harm you. They just stared at you.
Oh, they'd have harmed herself.
How the hell do you know that?
Because I had to listen to their stories every night. Now they'd look at her by the fence. Then they'd tell me how they'd like to touch her.
Yeah, but first, they looked at her. Carol, listen to me. You gotta go out there to them.
Yeah.
Terror once again treks its legendary course, making your flesh creep with pleasure. Night, when the unliving rise again from their graves, you will tremble with the return of the evil dead. Their hellborn revenge, for which there is no assurance of protection, nor will you escape the fear, the anxiety which the return of the evil dead provokes. A new high in excitement. Help me! The return of the evil dead. The Return of the Evil Dead with Tony Kendall and Fernando Sancho. The terrifying thriller of the year. Do not attend this film alone. We suggest you bring at least one large partner to hold you tightly. The lifeless horsemen will make this theater into a living horror. The Return of the Evil Dead. The return of the evil dead. You sure you're in fit condition? And don't scream.
Children had a party.
It's party time.
It was Orville's coming out party. Oh, they had so much fun. They laughed and laughed and laughed. That is, until Orville's friends dropped in. Oh, children shouldn't play with dead things.
Attention, please. The motion picture you are about to see contains certain very stomach-upsetting scenes. The producers feel they have a moral obligation to warn each and every ticket buyer of this fact. Although most people have the ability to cope with the sudden nausea and shock, there are some people who cannot handle it. Test audiences, after watching this motion picture, suggested that a warning of some sort be included before each scene they felt to be upsetting. Therefore, the producers have inserted a special warning buzzer and picture of a patron reacting to the scene. When you see the man turning green and the buzzer sounding, those of you who feel you cannot take it, please do not look at the screen. Here is what to look for. It is your only warning of the scene coming up. Thank you for your cooperation.
Son, knowing that your mother's in the finest of hands, we'll see you at the service tomorrow. In the meantime, you can visit with your mother in slumber room 6. We call it the Golden Years Room.
Thank you, sir. We really appreciate your concern.
Thank you very much. Goodbye, sir. Happy Halo Funeral Home.
Dr. Zare up here. I think we've got some business for you.
Wonderful.
Do you think you'll be able to fit him in tonight?
Of course we can accommodate him.
Good.
Business is never good enough, you know.
Do you think you can take this guy out of our cold room tonight?
I'll let Bill stay a little later.
No, that's no trouble. How badly?
Well, he looks as if he was mauled by a bear's face as he passed.
Oh, well. You know, we're the finest in town when it comes to restoring faces. Oh, Bill, I wonder if you'd mind staying a little later tonight. We've got a rush case coming over from the hospital. Might be just a little bit of a challenge to you. Some sort of an accident. Okay?
No, I don't mind. Kind of like those hardcore cases. And Mrs. Sandini was no pushover.
Is this Mrs. Sangini that came in this morning? Nice job.
Yeah, I'm kind of proud of that one myself.
Bill, we'll move her into with that young girl in room 6, and I will move her out tomorrow. We'll see you later. Bon appetit, and Bill, not too much booze.
dead people weren't as sweet as people like to remember them as being. Take the kid who's coming in tonight. He must be there by now. Ceremony. We'll fix them up, clean them up, and put them on show for everybody to look at. And no one will ever know it was a bear. Huh? Should be finishing by now. I guess I'd better get back.
You know, Bill, he doesn't look quite right to me. His cheeks need filling out a little bit, I think. Have you got any cotton batting with you?
There's some here in my pocket.
Yeah, we'll see if we can fill it out a little bit. It looked like an angel when I got through with him.
Ah!
Hang on a second. I'll take my return.
Okay, I'll wait as well. Are you waiting for Sherry to get out? Yeah, I think that's all right. Okay. Here's all right. Yeah.
Lisa, what's the matter?
Yeah, what's your problem anyway?
Oh, shut up.
Pass me another beer, please, Alan.
Yeah.
Look, let's do something different tonight.
Like what?
Hey, I got it. Let's go to that rock concert in Bakersville. They got some really good groups there.
A rock concert? Christ, we've been to every one for the past month. No, there must be something different.
What do you want to do, Lisa?
I don't care.
I've got it. Today's Friday the 13th, right?
Yeah.
Let's spend a night in a graveyard.
A graveyard?
Why not? Who knows who we'll meet there? Maybe Count Dracula.
I've got some grass. We could really blow our minds there.
A graveyard? No way, baby.
Oh, come on. Let's be fair about this. You girls want to go to a rock show. We want to go to the graveyard. So we'll draw straws. Short one is the graveyard, long one the rock concert.
No. Alan, I don't want to go.
I'll even let you draw that way. You can't complain it was rigged.
Might as well. Son of the
bitch. One problem. Where's the nearest graveyard?
Up near Bakersfield, about 30 miles back in the bush. There's an old mining town there, but all the ore ran out, everybody left. It hasn't been used in years.
Well, we better go if we want to get there before dark.
Alan, you're not serious, are you?
Well, sure I am. Come on, let's go.
Come on. Lisa, people are dying to get into this place. Well, are you coming out or not?
Look, you said we go to the graveyard, but nobody said anything about getting out of this car.
Richie, you want to get the sleeping bags out of the trunk? I'll see if I can find some place to bed down. How about that old vault over there?
And how do you propose to get in? Dynamite the door, hey?
Let's go see.
Been here for years. My loved one sleeps here. Can't make out the name. Looks like Simons. Died 1918.
Hey, you guys, it's starting to rain.
The vault's right over here. It's on. It's open.
Maybe one of its permanent residents went out for a walk. Alan, come on. Let's get the hell out of here.
For Christ's sake, Lisa, quit being a drag. Will you come on? Come on.
Something. Like what? I'm cold.
Well, my My uncle used to tell stories about spirits and things. Used to draw... Here, move out of there. Has anybody got anything? He used to draw circles and stuff. Here, let's see. Like this. Here now, come on. Come on, you get over here. Come on. And Lisa and Alan, come on. Here,
what
move
are
in
we,
here.
What,
just
get, what kneel are down. We doing?
Just kneel down, come on. Now put your hands in the circle.
Ooh.
Put your here. Give me this. Out of the way. Now put your hands in the circle. Doesn't matter. Just put your hand down now. And you, come on. And Lisa. There. Now there were words. Oh yeah. And concentrate. You gotta concentrate on something and close your eyes. Keep your eyes closed. And just concentrate on anything. Concentrate on something. What were the words? Lucifer, Lucifer. I got it. Okay, you concentrating?
Mm-hmm.
Now, Lucifer, Lucifer, Barabbas, Barabbas, Santanus, by Santanus, come, 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 draw, Miro, Esenaroth, Betu, Baro, Mara.
I always thought your uncle was a fake. Now what?
Well, he disappeared pretty weirdly. Oh, this is ridiculous, Richard.
Come on, come
like
on.
Game
no, there's something wrong. Just... Maybe... Here. There, maybe that'll work. I know I got the words right. That's gotta work.
What are you doing?
Oh, humor him. Besides, the rain's letting up.
I don't know. I don't like this. I'm beginning to feel a little strange.
Just forget it.
No,
come
Richie,
on, let's try
mean
it again.
I feel
put your
weird.
Hands the way they were before. Come on, everybody, put your hands the way you. Okay. Now concentrate. And close your eyes. Everybody concentrate. Now come on, let's try it again. It's gonna work. Lucifer! Lucifer! Barabbas, Barabbas, by Santanus, Santanus, come! Come!
I think it came from outside.
We're going to chat.
Thank you.
there.
That just came in.
Yes, doctor. Looks pretty serious. I wonder what happened.
He'll be all right, doctor, won't he?
Come on, Lisa, you're in the way. He'll be okay.
Nurse.
Yes, doctor.
Did you get a blood type on him and prepare for surgery at once? He's lost a lot of blood. Oh, ring for the elevator.
Yes, doctor.
And, oh, nurse, can you tell Dr. Zara they'll need his assistance?
But Dr. Zara's on maternity call.
I don't care what he's on. This man is dying.
Dying, doctor, he can't die. He's all I've got left.
Is she related to him?
Yes, he's her brother.
Dr. L. Shaycock.
We're taking him up to the 7th floor. You can wait up there. I'll need a full report on this later. I don't know whether we can save him. These wounds are pretty serious.
I'll get his arm.
Dr. Ball.
Can you get him now? Oh, he's pretty strong even in his condition.
Okay, hold him still now. Take it easy, young man. We just want to take a little bit of blood.
Sorry to take you off maternity on such short notice, doctor, but this kid's in pretty rough shape. Can't understand why his shoulder's so badly mangled. Bears don't do that.
To tell you the truth, I don't mind at all. We had one delivery about 5 hours ago, and I don't think much else will be happening tonight.
You know, doctor, being on emergency is much the same as being on maternity. They either all seem to arrive at once or none at all. Can't seem to spread themselves out. Well, that does me.
There now, that's better. Doctor should be finished scrubbing by now. And the boy seems to be quieter. I think you can let him go.
What exactly is the condition of our patient?
Well, he has a severed artery near the neck and some deep cuts in the shoulder and chest areas. He's lost a lot of blood and his pulse is very weak. There's a chance we'll be able to save him. How he ever got like that, I'd like to know.
We're ready in the OR, doctor.
Thank you.
Dr. Beckstein. Dr. Beckstein.
How is he, Doctor? Will he be all right?
Richie, he's all right.
How serious is it?
I'm sorry, but we did everything we could to save him. I can't understand it. The system seemed to reject everything we did to help it function normally. Can't understand it. We had trouble typing his blood earlier. Transfusions we gave him just didn't seem to take. This is a really strange case. But we'll find out what went wrong eventually. I am sorry. And I assure you, Dr. Zarov's an excellent surgeon.
Lisa, Lisa, the doctor, she's passed out.
She'll be all right. It's just the shock of losing her brother. Nurse?
Yes, doctor.
Put this girl in one of the recovery rooms overnight.
Sorry.
Administer a sedative. It'll help her come out of it better. Would you like to step into my office? I'd like to find out more about the background to this case.
There now. That should help you relax and have a good sleep tonight. You should want anything. Just press on the buzzer here. Someone just down the hall. Good night.
Good
Thank you.
Lisa? Oh! What's the matter? Are you okay? Oh. Lisa?
Well, I just had the most terrible vision. I dreamt I saw Richie at the funeral home. And he was awful.
Okay, okay, calm down. It's all right. It's a good thing you were given a sedative. It'll start to work soon. Do you want anything, the nurse?
No. I'm all right now. But that dream, Alan, it was terrible.
Look, come on, it's all right. Now just relax. Try and get some sleep. Everything will be okay.
All right. I'm all right now. I feel better.
Oh, that's good. I've just come back from the doctor's office, and I think he's going to call the police. I don't think he believes what I tried to tell him.
Alan, why did we go there? Richie would still be alive if we hadn't gone to that stupid cemetery.
Don't talk like that, Lisa. You're blaming yourself for nothing.
But why, Alan? Why did it happen? We could have had just as much fun doing something else.
Look, you're upsetting yourself for nothing. What happened, it just happened. Nobody was responsible for it. Now pull yourself together.
Well, tell me Richie's not dead. Please.
Okay, it's all right. Remember the last time we did something way out? All the fun we had, didn't we? No, let's not have any more nonsense about all of us being responsible, okay?
Well, Bill, I guess you're pretty tired, so I'll just say goodnight. Get back to all those forms and red tape you have to go through to bury some dead piece of meat.
Fine, I'll just lock up on the way out then.
Okay, good night, Bill.
Good night.
Who the hell can that be at this time of the night? Those
Okay, okay, I'm coming. Hello? Hello? Who's there? I better go down and check to see what's going on down there.
Going on.
Hey. Hey, you. What are you doing there? Where is everybody?
Thank you. Right outside the front door. You know this whole area used to be Indian territory?
Come on to the picnic, Shelly. Might as well live like Indians as long as we're up here.
Aw, these Indians don't go on picnics.
Will you be quiet? I got her just where I want her. Seven spaces in front of boardwalk.
Okay, but you're missing out on a good time.
Come on.
Come here to have fun, and all she wants to do is play Monopoly.
Don't worry about it. She's alone. Of a hunting arrow, okay? And then this used to fit on a larger spear for hunting bigger game, like, you know, deer.
How come you know so much about Indians?
I'm an old Boy Scout. It's my duty to know. Besides, I grew up in this area. You know, it's all I ever heard was Indian legends and stories, you know, the whole bit. You want to know something interesting?
For a change, you mean?
You know this place we're staying? Used to be part of an old Indian burial ground. Very sacred and holy.
Ooh, scary. What, is it cursed or something?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, it is.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Don't worry about it. You're only cursed by the evil spirits if you violate the graves of the dead. We're just going to be eating hot dogs. Besides, I'm there to protect you.
You?
Yeah.
You're going to protect me?
Yeah. Hey! I'm going to build a fire for the hot dogs. Why don't you see if you can find some wood?
Okay.
Be 200 years old. Indian dagger. God, it's in perfect shape. Oh, my.
What's it doing here?
Well, as far as I know, when the medicine man of a tribe died, they used to bury one of his possessions with him so he could have it in his next life.
Oh, you mean we're having a picnic over somebody's dead body?
Yeah, but all that's left now is Tinga, the Indian spirit of the woods, who watches over and protects the medicine man's grave for all eternity.
Oh, hold me, I'm scared.
To jail. Do not pit.
Damn it, I hate this game.
Oh, really? Because you're losing now.
Oh, I'm sure. This game's for fat old spastic people that don't know any better. I can't do any damn thing. I hate this loading game.
Well, 20 minutes ago you didn't think so.
Yeah, well, that was different either. That was different.
And why was that different?
I was winning.
Bruce! gone back to the cottage without me. Scotty, is that you? Please, who's there? Answer me!
All right.
Bruce
he's
dead.
Dead.
Bruce? Oh,
no. I saw him. He was on the ground. He was all cut up. Oh,
wait a minute. God. Are you sure it's Bruce? Did you see his face?
I was sleeping.
Okay, sir.
And I woke up, and then I started running.
All right, you can talk to Steve. You're making any sense out of her. I can't.
It's okay, Alan. You were having a nightmare. You could have just been sleeping.
All right, listen. Maybe Bruce is hurt. I'm going to go outside and look for him. I want you to take care of her
careful,
until I get
be
back.
Be careful. Let's go in the kitchen and get something to eat. Then we'll get changed. And I'll bet you in 30 seconds, Bruce and Scott will come through the door laughing their heads off. Just don't worry about it.
Probably rounding up the picnic basket and blanket, that's all. Hey, there's some food on the stove. Now you wait here. I'm gonna go take a look myself.
No, please, don't go out there.
I'm just gonna step outside and shine the light into the woods.
Join us.
I'd like to.
Quick. Sell her. Gun. Hurry.
The gun.
Thank you.
Thank you ever so much for watching another fine late night feature. I hope you enjoyed watching as much as we enjoyed showing it to you. Right, Lightning? Oh, sure, Lightning enjoyed showing it to you, too.
I can also tell you how to order my book, The Cosmic Wisdom of Joe Bob Briggs. Got to get that plug in every week. And that's about it for me. We do have a death to report tonight, I'm sorry to say. The historic Asher Drive-In in Little Rock, Arkansas, site of the world premiere of Sweet Sweet Connie. That was the one that starred Connie the groupie from the song An American Band. Remember that? Grand Funk Railroad. The Asher Drive-In is being torn down for a multi-screen indoor bull-stuffed movie house, and this is the last remaining drive-in in Little Rock. Doug Treadway sends two words, save us, and reminds us that without eternal vigilance, it can happen here. That's it. Do you guys know the difference between a Polish phone booth and the Warsaw Public Library? The phone booth has a book in it. Joe Bob Briggs reminding you that the drive-in will never die. Eventually, I'm going to run out of those.